This is Whispering Lim doing another unboxing video for you today. This is my August Munch Pak, and I'll just barely get the video in on August, unfortunately. I have had a bit of a month, so I'm sorry that this is a little late, but at least we're here now, right? Just jump right into it. I'm not going to explain what Munch Pak is about, other than to say it's a bunch of snacks from all over the world. If you're a fan of unboxing videos, I'm sure you've gotten the spiel before, so. Da-da-da. Go ahead and put that down nice and gently. I did cheat and I slightly opened this beforehand, but I've only tried one thing and I'm gonna retry it for this. I didn't have my settings quite right for the video. But today's Munch Pak is brought to me by Roxy. And first up is, if I can get it out. Coney Island kettle corn. And this one is cinnamon bun flavored. So, I do love kettle corn, but I don't understand why it had to be cinnamon bun flavored. Like, I think the standard kettle corn flavor is delicious. In fact, there's a local company that does it that, I guess because I grew up on theirs, everything else doesn't quite compare. But let's give it a go, huh? So it's, they call it cinnamon bun flavor, and there is a bit of cinnamon in there. But it's not a very strong flavor. I think it's probably good for snacking, but I kind of anticipated something with a bit more impact, you know? And because it's a dry product, you don't get that gooey funness that I normally associate with a cinnamon bun. So, obviously I like it enough to keep eating it. But, yeah, it's not bad. I always think it's funny that they insist on putting an American treat in here. At least this time it was something, different. Because I've never had Coney Island popcorn, so yay for that. This is definitely foreign, so I'm gonna go with this next. Some sort of, I'm gonna guess that's a corn on the cob creature. And let's see here, corn cracker. And it is a product of Japan. I always love getting Asian products, so that's nice. Definitely has a very thick kind of wrapping. So we're not gonna tear this open. We're gonna go ahead and try to gently cut it open. Maybe from the bottom, since it looks a little less crinkled at the bottom. I'm gonna guess that these unboxing videos are good to do. One of my more persistent commenters loved it, but I haven't gotten any other sort of feedback, so I'm not sure. But I'm gonna go ahead and keep doing these because I just love trying all the snacks, I think. So that's a lot bigger than I anticipated. Definitely a big crunchy corn puff type deal. Bit of a straw. Mm. So it's a spiced corn puff. And I can't quite discern what spice it is. The ingredients say broad bean chili paste. Oh, okay, so it's a chili type thing. And then it just says spices, because, you know, they can't reveal their secret formula. That has, you know, a mild amount of kick to it, and it does remind me of the kind of flavor profile that chili would have, so. So I don't know what it's called. It's not in English, but it's pretty good. So yay, I'm excited. So far I haven't hated anything out of my Munch Pak. I actually get these bi-weekly, and so I really should have done an August one sooner, but the first one I got this month had a bunch of repeat flavors and boring flavors, and I got halfway through the video and I was like, no, I can't post that, so I have some standards. Not many, but a few. We have another corn snack nice on top, but I'm gonna wait on that for a second. I always like having sort of a flip-flop between the different sort of textures so that your buds over there don't get bored of the same thing. So let's find something with a different texture. This looks like it'll fit the bill. It looks like Japanese writing, but it doesn't actually specify. I'm gonna assume it's a Japanese product. And based on the picture, if I can get the glare off there, probably soda flavored, like a cola, and considering the powdery nature, either it's gonna, well, there might be a stick in there, maybe it's more like fun dip. My initial thought that it was that maybe it'd be carbonated, but I might not be that lucky. I love Pop Rocks and things like that. Oh, there's definitely a stick in here that's making it hard to tear. Back to our handy friend, the scissors. Well, at least this opens nicely. I could probably get that close to the microphone. Okay, so it's got a lollipop that's all covered in powder. I'm gonna say that's their attempt at cola. It doesn't remind me specifically of Coke or Pepsi, but definitely soda of some sort. I assume that since there's so much powder in here, that the idea is that you lick and dip. The lollipop on its own, the powder is kind of a tart flavor, a little acidic, so I feel like it doesn't really add anything to the dessert other than the fun of, you know, dipping it. So not bad, but you know, not fantastic either. So next up, I think I'll try this one. It looks interesting. And I can, you know, there's at least Roman letters on it, so I can read it. Maybe read it. Dubrogia Eugenia. Let's see where this is from. It's always my favorite part of these is just kind of finding out where in the world we're trying this from. You know, I think you kind of find out that in the end there's a few weird flavors, but mostly we all eat the same things. So, Romania, there we go. We found its origin. And so it's from Romania, and it's some sort of cream biscuit. Biscotti con molta crema de lapte si vanilla. So it's a vanilla flavored cookie. Let's find out how Romania does their vanilla flavored cookies. Okay, so comes with two kind of exploded biscuits here. This is the risk of having international food, is that it tends to usually get broken. So I'd give it maybe a C if I was grading it on a letter scale. There's nothing really special about it, but passing grade for a cookie. A little bit of a letdown, but that's okay. I definitely enjoy, you know, kind of trying to expand my palate a little bit. But I think, as I just mentioned, you know, you end up finding out that a lot of things just taste the same. Maybe they're not exactly the same, but I don't get as many unusual or like strange flavors as one would think when you're eating foreign food. I'm not sure if that's a problem with Munch Pak itself, or if, like I said, you know, all around the world we all kind of just like the same things in the end. So next up, Skwinkolote. That's quite a mouthful right there. Tierra de los Doce enchilado sobre pina con relleno sobre tamarindo. Okay, so I can tell just by the description that that is a Mexican candy or something Latin. Pineapple hot candy. And let's see, let's confirm wherever it's from. Maybe. Yep, Mexico. So, this might be interesting though. I'm optimistic. Or if it's just really fitting, but it kind of looks like a taquito, you know, kind of that you'd get in the frozen food section. So, yeah, it's kind of gummy at least. Very common in Hispanic candies. It's like a spice of some sort in it. My palate is just compelled to eat another piece, and I'm not sure why, but I don't like it. One more little bite. No. Nope, 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 nope. It's not even that it's too spicy, although it is fairly spicy for a candy. My real problem is that I just don't like that particular, you know, flavorant. And I thought that maybe once I got used to it, you know, go for the second bite, that, you know, the pineapple and everything would help me, like, melt the flavors together in my mind, but no, that was not the case. But on the plus side, that was the most unique thing I've tried in a while, so it's been a while since I've had Hispanic candy, so that was good. In the sense that I got to try something different, not so much in the actual flavor. But it's not about your destination, it's about the journey, right? So next up we have some nuts, some pecans, or pecans, depending on which part of the world you're from, or the states. Big debate over whether it's pecan. I usually say pecan unless I'm really thinking about the word, and then I say pecan. So, from Santa Clara, California. So we've got another American treat, but at least it's something of quality. I love nuts, and they're not the cheapest thing in the world, so I think I can get behind the fact that this is American. Honestly, candy pecans sound divine right now. So, let's find out. I just want to, like, shove this whole thing in my mouth. Tastes just like a pecan pie without, you know, the creamy factor on your palate. Butter, sugar, salt, that's it. Sometimes you can't argue with the basics, though. I could probably eat that whole bag, but I'm gonna limit it to one more little go after I play with the cracking noise, because this is an audio-centric video after all, right? Don't you love nuts? I mean, they're... God, that's gonna get taken out of context, isn't it? I should probably stop myself. And that was tasty. Really, really tasty. So, I'll take a quick pause to say that if anyone out there, other than Honey Whisper, which I'll give you a second shout out, likes these unboxing videos, let me know, because I'm actually considering ordering a few other boxes of things. I've got a Graze pack coming in the mail, which is more health food oriented. It's not healthy, but like more natural food, I guess, is the better description there, because can't always eat the junk food. So I got that. And I don't know, there's just a couple of ones that have caught my eye. So if this is the sort of thing that appeals to you, let me know so that I feel more justified in purchasing them. I have fun with them, and I definitely, you know, enjoy trying things, and I like having something to do for my videos other than draw, because I'm not always in an artistic sort of mood. So hit me up, comments below, please. But moving on, next up we have yummy gummy candy, sour rainbow belts. So this is a product of Turkey. I'm gonna guess that it's gonna taste exactly like the Airheads sour belts because it looks the same. But we'll see. We'll see. At least this one's not hard to open. It's so hard to find a noise that's pleasant, but that my microphone doesn't distort. So I like it when things open up nicely. So anyways, it's exactly what I was expecting. So it's just a Turkey version of an Airhead. I'll probably continue eating them just because I kind of like Airheads, but maybe not that whole pack. That's a lot. I'm kind of bummed. I don't feel as like excited as I was for the first couple of treats. I feel like I need some coffee or something. I'm getting kind of like sleepy myself. So hopefully that means you guys are nice and relaxed. I don't know what I'm doing most of the time. But I do know that the next one that I'm going to try is Oblita Dulce de Leche. So just based on the title, it's gonna be some sort of caramel wafer. I'm trying to figure out where it's from. So that's always a big thing with me, as I'm sure I've said before. You'd think they'd standardize where that information would be. But I really have no idea. Oh, I found it. It's made in Argentina. That took some searching. There is a little app that Munch Pak puts out where you can scan the barcode and it'll give you more information and the country of origin without having to do what I was just doing, but I think playing with my phone too much in the middle of the video would probably be a little distracting. That's my guess anyways. Like I said, I just fly by the seat of my pants and shake my fist at the neighbors. But we're almost there. We're almost at the end, so sound of that coming out. We'll see how that sounds. And since it's a wafer cookie, the obligatory snap. So for those who've never had dulce de leche, it's just basically caramel. But this one has a different note to it, which is why I'm reading the ingredient list here. Okay. That's what's throwing me off. It's artificially flavored. I have no idea why in the world you would artificially flavor dulce. Like, caramel is just burnt sugar. I can't imagine chemicals being cheaper than burning sugar. It's not necessarily bad, but it's just confusing me, you know? Almost has a bit of a coconut vibe to it, but it doesn't say coconut anywhere on the list, so it's very bizarre. But not bad. It's worth trying. We're down to one last snack, so let's hope we end with a bang. Maybe. I'm kind of having my doubts. Oh no, I've got two snacks. I lie. Okay, we'll save the best for last. But this one, I do not think will be the best. Looks like a off-brand of Oreo. Escureto. And let's see here. Biscoito sobre chocolate con reggio sobre. Oh god. I'm so bad. I took 4 years of Spanish and I still can't read it. It's terrible. Let's see here. Where are you from? I mean, I know it's going to be Brazil. So we kind of have a Latin theme today. You know, I'm not necessarily complaining over, but it's different. I don't think I've had so many Latin America foods in a box before. And it broke, so I could just lick the cream off. But for the first bite, we'll go ahead and go for the whole deal. Not bad. And it is an Oreo for all intents and purposes, but there's another flavor element in this one that I don't quite recognize. And of course it's not gonna say. So ingredients are just wheat flour, sugars, oil, cocoa powder, starch, caramel ivy, I don't know what that is, baking powder, blah, blah, blah. It's not bad. But if you want an Oreo, I wouldn't go for it because it is a little different. So we do have one last treat. Golden sweet corn. I actually really love corn snacks, so I'm kind of excited. This one's made in the Philippines, and it's very, very full of air. Make a little rattle. Doesn't seem to be that full though. You know, just air, not product. One of my earlier Munch Packs had a corn snack that was corn porridge flavored from Japan. So I'm curious to see how this one stacks up. The one that I had before was, what would you say? Tasted like cream corn. And I would imagine that this one's going to do the same, but let's find out. So they're little balls. I like the one that I had before better, because this one doesn't have the parsley in it, which the one that I had from Japan did, but it's still acceptable to me. All right then, that is all of our desserts today. I think it was a fun pack in that I got to try a couple of things I wouldn't normally try, and I had a few things that I really like, so maybe a 7 out of 10 for today. But at any rate, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.